Bienvenue.
Willkommen.
Welcome. Today, we are going to talk about the creation of the European flag.
And challenge some misconceptions about it.
Who created it?
Was the flag originally sky blue?
Does it have religious connotations? So, buckle up.
Because we are going to tell you everything you need to know.
About the creation of the European flag. As strange as it may seem, the European flag was not created by the European Union, nor by its predecessor, the European Economic Community. In fact, it was the brainchild of the Council of Europe, an international organization based in Strasbourg. Like the EC, the Council of Europe was created after the Second World War with the aim of peacefully unite the continent. At the time, Europe, as a political and cultural entity, lacked an official and recognizable symbol. That's why the people at the Council of Europe wanted to adopt an emblem that would not only represent their organization but also give to the Europeans a shared symbol of their unity. In 1950, when they started their work, two pro-European associations had already created their own flags. The European Movement had adopted in 1948 a green letter E on a white background. Green was the color of hope, and E was the first letter of Europe. It was not very aesthetic. In fact, some people compared it to white underpants lying on the grass. Nevertheless, this emblem was by far the most well-known and the most influential. The Pan-European Union, on the other hand, had used since 1923 a blue flag with a gold disc and a red cross. The Council of Europe received around 150 proposals for the new flag. Their contents were very diverse and varied. Some were green and white. Others tried to combine the colors of the existing national flags. Some featured a cross to represent Europe's Christian heritage. Stars. A capital E. Strasbourg's coat of arms. A triangle representing culture. And so on. Yellow stars on a navy blue background were already a thing. Karl Rehmann, a German citizen who was living in Japan, proposed a single star on a blue background. Unfortunately, this design was identical to the flag of Belgian Congo. Salvador de Madariaga created a flag with 29 stars. Each star marked the position of a European capital, with a bigger star representing Strasbourg. A committee was tasked to review the proposals and selected 12 of them. One of these proposals was nearly identical to the flag of the Pan-European Union. Other ones consisted of a single cross, with green and white, or red and white colors. Two proposals incorporated the letter E in a clever way, forming a cross with 4E, or using the maritime signal flag representing the letter. The latter, by the way, was identical to the civil flag of Haiti, which had already forced Liechtenstein to change its flag. But nobody seemed to notice. One used the most common colors found in the national flags of European countries. Three of them were inspired by the USA. One featured the white star of the US Army that liberated Europe several years earlier. One was basically the American flag, but with blue and white stripes and yellow stars in a red rectangle. The last one dropped the stripes and kept only the stars. And then, there was this ugly mess. The flag of the Pan-European Union was by far the preferred design. The USA flag with blue stripes was a distant second, and was criticized for being too American. Unfortunately, the Council of Europe had a Muslim member, Turkey, which opposed the adoption of a flag featuring a cross. It was suggested that Turkey could use a version of the flag with a crescent on the upper left-hand corner. A version with a red compass instead of a red cross was also proposed, without success. But most members of the Council agreed that blue, not green, should be the color of Europe. Gold stars were appreciated, although obvious references to the USA should be avoided. Salvador de Madariaga's design matched these criteria, but was deemed too difficult to draw. It seemed that several departments of the Council of Europe and several people had the idea of a circle of stars around the same time. This design was already present in the 150 initial proposals. A German citizen, Hanno Konopath, had proposed the same design to the Hamburg section of the European movement. Despite a last-minute attempt by Robert Bichet to adopt a circle of green stars on a white background, the committee voted to present a navy blue flag featuring a circle of 15 gold stars. The 15 stars were supposed to represent the member states, but would not change with the addition of new members. They were arranged in a circle as a sign of union. It also had a practical advantage: other European institutions could personalize the flag by adding their own logo inside the circle. The emblem was adopted by the Assembly of the Council of Europe in September 1953. The design was then sent to the Committee of Ministers, who rejected it due to opposition by Germany. Indeed, one of the members of the Council of Europe was Saarland, which Germany considered to be one of its regions, and didn't want to see it represented by a star like an independent state. The question was thus sent back to a committee composed of experts in heraldry and members of the Assembly. This committee first suggested a circle of interlocked gold rings, but this proposal was quickly rejected. Finally, they decided to keep the circle of stars, but reduced their number to 12, instead of 15. The number 12 was chosen as a symbol of plenitude and perfection. And in December 1955, after 5 years of efforts to find the right emblem, the 12-star flag on an azure background was officially adopted by the Council of Europe. The emblem was so successful that the other flags of the European movements were quickly forgotten. In 1986, it was adopted by the European Community.
Now you can see it everywhere.
On logos.
On official buildings.
On banknotes.
In front of Swedish furniture shops.
It has become the unrivaled symbol of unity for all European citizens. If you search the internet for the 15-star version of the European flag, you may encounter a variation with a lighter shade of blue. Indeed, at the time of this recording, two light blue designs can be found on the Flag of Europe Wikipedia page. The 15-star flag adopted by the Assembly in 1953, and the subsequent proposal featuring a circle of 8 rings. But in this video, we showed you two dark blue flags. So, why the difference? The light blue versions are the result of a misinterpretation of the official documents of the Council of Europe. The English version of these documents states that the flags are sky blue. However, on the same documents, the heraldic term used for the color is azure. In heraldry, azure generally refers to a dark blue color, as opposed to bleu céleste, or light blue. The explanation lies in the French version of the documents. In French, the background of the flag is described as bleu comme le ciel, or blue like the sky. Thus, sky blue refers to the symbolism, not the shade, of the color blue. Someone didn't understand that, and uploaded light blue versions of the actual proposals. As for why the rings are white and not gold, we have no idea. Maybe a confusion with the flag of the United Nations? You may have heard this one before. Arsenites, the creator of the European flag, claimed in the late 80s that his inspiration was the crown of 12 stars of the Virgin Mary. Journalists and the media may enjoy this bit of trivia, but there is a little problem here. Indeed, as we explained in this video, Arsenites is not the creator of the European flag. I repeat, Arsenites is not the creator of the European flag. Arsenites was not the only one, nor the first, to suggest a circle of gold stars on a blue background. None of his proposals are perfectly identical to the final design, or its 15-star version. As we explained in this video, the gold and blue colors were inspired by the flag of the Pan-European Union. The stars were an obvious choice to represent the states, like on the American flag. Salvador de Madariaga's proposal, another well-liked design, also featured gold stars on a dark blue field. Written documents of the time show that several people had the idea of arranging the stars in a circle. Moreover, the first proposal featured a circle of 15 stars, not 12. Nobody, not even Arsen Eitz, had proposed a circle of 12 stars before that. So the number of stars is a mere coincidence, due to the Saarland problem. Finally, Paul Levy maintains that it was him, not Arsen Eitz, who designed the template of the final flag. Thus, all we have is an unverifiable claim made by Arsen Eitz 30 years after the facts. The reality is that the creation of the European flag was the result of a collaborative effort. Arsen Eitz's participation in this effort was real, but not a determinant one. That's all for today.
We hope you enjoyed this video.
See you next time.
And until then, keep the head in the stars.